sister had her mullet. Remember the, like how she had her? Kind of like the mullet deal. Like, business in the front, party in the back. That's what I was like.
How the kids?
Man, they've been pretty good. Except for my boy. Yeah, he just don't like to sleep very well at night. He can't go to sleep. And guess who's up with him? I am.
Well, you gotta tell him bedtime stories.
Man, I've told him every single one in the book.
Yeah, but you, look, you tell him the same bedtime stories we heard. You gotta tell them bedtime stories and flip them around backwards.
Backwards?
Backwards. Okay, listen. I'm gonna tell you the story of Rinderzella. And you go home and tell it to your boy, all right?
Rinderzella?
Yeah, just listen. All right. Once a ton of pine in a corn country, there lived a beautiful bird, and her name was Rinderzella. She lived with her mowgli elders and her two sad blizzards. Also in this corn country lived a prancing hens, and he was going to have a fancy fall. And he was going to invite all the people, especially the pigeons. Well, Rinderzella's mowgli elder and her two sad blizzards, they took off to go buy him some transy pheasants. You know, to where his fancy fall. Well, Rinderzella knew she couldn't go, so when a night at the ball came, she just got down and tried. She got down and tried. And then, all of a sudden, appeared before her, her Gary Mudfather. And he touched her with his wagging mind.
Oh.
And then, appeared before them, a King Boach and Hicks White Sources to take her right on to the fancy fall. So they went down to the fancy fall, and there the prince of hens was waiting for him, because he had been watching the whole time behind with him. Well, they nanced all night. They was having a tittle gun. And they lell and fub.
They lell and fub?
They lell and fub. They lell and fub. And just all at once, the mid-clock struck nine. She strained out her ears, and just as she popped to the goblin, you know what she did?
What'd she do?
She slopped her dripper.
She slopped her dripper?
She slopped her
dripper. I hate when that happens.
Well, the next day, this prince of hens went all over the corn country looking for this beautiful bird who slopped her dripper. Well, he finally got to Rinderzella's house and trotted on her mowgli elder, and it fit in. He trotted on her two sad blisters, and it fit in. Then he tried it on Rinderzella, and it fit in. It was exactly the side drive.
Oh, man.
Well, they got married, and they lived heavily after happened. But look, Roy. The stroll of the Morees. If you want to go to a fancy ball and have a prince of hens lolling club with you, don't forget to slop your dripper.